What is going on, Adventure Nation? There is a few things in the apartment that are not quite the same, huh, Lorena?
No, we're missing the couch. There's boxes everywhere. It's like there's a lot of stuff gone.
And that's because we are closing out the Orlando chapter and starting a new chapter this fall. Are you excited, Lori?
I'm excited.
See you guys soon.
And now back to our regularly scheduled programming.
What is going on, Adventure Nation? Today we are on a new adventure, something I've never done before, and we're going to a cast event, so that's kind of cool. So our day is actually going to be starting here, and it's also going to finish here at Epcot. But in the middle, we got a little bit of fun stuff we're going to do. So I thought we'd bring you guys along for the ride. Let's get this show on the road. So we are starting our adventure here at Epcot, but we're not going into the park yet. We will be going into the park tonight after 7 p.m.
Yeah,
I think.
Event starts at 10, but we're allowed to start at 7.
Yeah, the event we're going to is called Iridescent, and I don't know how many events exactly they're doing, but it's all for cast members only. And you can do Magic Kingdom, Hollywood Studios, Epcot, or...
I think AK.
No, AK was not one. So Hollywood, Epcot, and Magic Kingdom. And of course, the most popular was Magic Kingdom and Hollywood Studios. And because I do everything last minute, the only one I could get is Epcot, but we like Epcot, so it'll be cool. Anyways, until we go into the cast party, we're gonna do some adventuring around, head on over, check out some boats, monorails, planes, trains, automobiles, all that kind of stuff. All right, we just got off the monorail from Epcot. Getting ready to jump on the ferry, head over to Magic Kingdom, and then we'll get on another boat, go somewhere else.
By the way, doesn't matter, we have access to the parks and we can make reservations. This is what one of Paul's favorite things to do in Disney. It's just ride everything.
Yeah, this is part of my rides. All the bus transportation, boats, all that stuff. That's part of the rides for me, so I kind of like it. Just kicking around and jumping on different modes of transportation and checking out different areas of the parks. So. Yeah, kind of cool.
Gates are closed. Last of the guests are aboard, and we are casting off.
You want to go up?
So is there any time? Q5, please move to just sitting or standing on the stairs while you're on the boat. Once again, folks, no sitting or standing on the stairs while you're on the boat. Thank you.
Close to the Magic Kingdom, and we're not going in, Lori.
Today is Epcot Day.
Now, from Epcot, we could have taken a bus straight to Fort Wilderness, but what's the fun in that? So, monorail first, then ferry, now boat over to Fort Wilderness. We're out in front of Magic Kingdom, but we're heading over to Fort Wilderness, so that's the way I like to do it.
Welcome aboard, advisor children. Now relax and enjoy your cruise, and we'll have you at your port call in just a few minutes.
Tetherball. All right, we have arrived at the Fort Wilderness Campground. We're just wandering around a little bit. Didn't realize it was food truck night, so we were checking out the food trucks back there. It's kind of cool.
Not too much for us, though.
Not too much for us crazy vegetarians, but we're used to that. We could always get ice cream there. Come over for ice cream dinner.
But, ice cream and mac and cheese.
Yeah, absolutely. We just confirmed our hoop-de-doo review reservations for August 31st, which is really cool. We're excited about that.
Oh my God, it's hard to get those reservations.
Very hard. Lori happened to scoop a couple spots for us, so that was great. Now we're going to head over to the horse stables here. We've never been over there. We're going to head over here and see if we can't check out the horses. Oh, this loop I'm in all the time. So I'm working here. This is the loop that we come over. This is called the settlement loop. So if we're coming over from Magic Kingdom, this is where we drop off people here. And this is also the start and stop for internal buses in Fort Wilderness as well. That is the Tri-Circle D Ranch barn over there, and it's closed. So we're not going over there.
Quah, quah, quah. We were hoping to go and see the horses.
Of course it's closed, Lori. We're a little late in the day. We kind of knew that. Yeah. Do we want to take a bus out to the front, or do we want to walk out to the front?
Well, we're half an hour to go into the event. And by the way, this is a cast member event. But I'm invited too.
Yeah,
I'm his plus one.
She's my plus one. Yes, that is correct. Well, let's take a bus up front then.
Yes. All okay. Right.
Now, from the settlement back there, you can actually take a bus straight out to the outpost, which is on the very outside of the campground, and then you get a bus from there over to Epcot. We've decided, or at least I talked Lori into walking halfway to the Meadows outpost. Just check the Meadows outpost, and then we'll grab a bus from there, because it's about a mile to a mile and a quarter walk or something all the way out, and it's pretty hot out today.
We need to put our steps in.
We do need our steps in, plus we're going to get our steps in tonight at Epcot.
Yes.
Trust me on that one.
Yes.
And back to the event that we're doing tonight. It is called Earidescent. It is a cast only event that they've put on several nights.
Cast plus one.
So it's cast plus invitee events, and they've put them on, I'm again not sure how many, whether there's 10 or 20 of them, something like that, but all the different parks, they shut down the park and it's cast only after 10 o'clock. The park is going to be open from 10 to 1 a.m. And then they have all kinds of food and beverage that is free. Of course, the rides are free and there's other activities going on in there that is all just cast only. So we're super excited about this. Lori's going to fill up on churros.
I told Paul, don't judge me. Tonight is the night.
I'm going to fill up on sugary sodas. And I'll be Mickey. In a sugar coma for next week. Mickey bars. If there's Mickey ice cream bars, I'll definitely be filling up on those.
Is, yeah.
Well, then I'm going to be in a sugar coma for the next week. So I'm looking forward to it.
I'm going to be in a sugar coma.
Yeah. Don't know how many times that we're able to ride the rides. I'm assuming that most of them were able to ride multiple times.
Except for Guardians.
Guardians of the Galaxy will be a one and done. I don't know. We'll find out.
That is correct.
Yes. All right. Well, hopefully it's maybe a slow night or something and we can do it multiple times. Not likely. Probably not.
I don't know.
This is the Meadows Trading Post, and it's kind of in the middle of the campground where you can get all kinds of your sundries. It's kind of a nice little convenience store, and they have stuff that you can have for s'mores kits and things like that. So kind of cool. A second ago, it was sunny and all was good in the world. Now it is pouring rain.
But still sunny.
It's still sunny in spots, yes. Holy smokes. so mic broke. All right, so we have made it to Epcot. We got off the bus and we are absolutely soaking wet. It's pouring rain, so we're gonna hang out here underneath this lightning too. We're gonna hang out here for just a little bit and see if we can outlast the rain.
The event still starts in an hour and a half, so hopefully it gets better. But monsoon season in Florida, you never know.
All right, we're about to go in to Iridescent. It's wet.
Welcome in, have fun today.
Yeah! Woo! Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you.
I think it's not raining anymore.
How fun is that?
It was. And we got our poncho after the fact.
Now that we're already soaking wet. All right, we've made it into Iridescent Evening here. And let me see here. This is it. Iridescent Evening. The camera's going to be a little bit wet. Oh,
they
and then this too.
Like a special thing. Like it's for him only.
Yeah, so very cool. Camera's going to be a little bit wet. We're going to be a little blurry.
Our bracelets,
and then we've got our ponchos, but now we're soaking wet anyway, so it doesn't really matter
just
at this point.
But
just in case it starts pouring in. So let's get into it. Start going and having some fun.
Yes. Still not churro yet, but coming up.
Woo! All right, it's not even 10 yet, and we've already started with the snacking. We've got our popcorn buckets that we've got. Lori's got her popcorn bucket as well. She's got her Mickey bar. I've got my Mickey bar as well, and then we've got Cokes and drinks and everything already starting down there. So, yeah, by the end of the night, we're gonna be tossing a lot of pounds.
We're gonna be rolling out, walking out.
Yeah, it's gonna be delicious though. All right, now we're getting into the churros.
Churro time. And pretzels.
Getting into the pretzels.
Mini pretzel.
Soda, ice cream. Got the DJ going over here.
We're the ice cream. The ice cream is very important.
Got a DJ going over there. Got Iridescent Evenings on the wall over there. This is going to be a super fun night.
Yes.
And I've got my Iridescent buddy with me.
Let's have fun.
We're going to party with Chipperdale. Bring it in.
Obviously, everybody's partying over here in your test track.
And Chippendale. Dancing with everybody.
Dancing with Chippendale, absolutely. So we're going to break out of that for just a minute. We're going to head over and do a ride here and do test track. And then maybe we'll check out Guardians after that. But so much fun so far. We've only been here for an hour. It's crazy.
The vibe is good, I have to say.
The vibe is really good. We go on test track. Woo!
SIM card performance data acquired.
All so much fun. Now we're going to head back into World Showcase and more food.
We haven't even made it there yet.
Yeah.
Yeah, you guys are going to find it hard to believe, but we're eating again. I have a Coke, churro, along with Lori's churro.
Churro tears.
And then we have another pretzel.
Churro tears.
Churro. Cheers. Cheers on the churro.
Judgment free zone right here. Mm. Let's talk to the kitchen.
Mickey pretzel.
And good we stuff. Need to stay hydrated.
Yes, stay hydrated. All right, Lori and I were just here filling our face. They came around and gave us some new ears.
Oh my God, you have such a big head.
Yeah, it they don't really fit on my head. There.
We get to be kids for a few moments.
Get to be kids for a few moments, absolutely.
I will say, Lorena, we have never been in any of the parks with this few people in it.
I know. It's so nice to just walk around. Oh, it's not hot whatsoever, by the way.
The weather's perfect.
Perfect. There's almost no people. So it's like all the park for us with the attractions open.
Yeah.
So it's just nice.
Absolutely incredible. And just such a fun, fun night. Now we're heading over to Norway because we heard there's desserts.
I cannot eat anymore, Paul.
We can eat some more, just a little bit more. I have faith in you, Lori.
We'll try.
Hey, Lorena, how long's the wait for Frozen today?
I think like probably 5 minutes.
Woohoo! Backpack would have been a great idea tonight. Well, it's 12:55 a.m. and Lori and I are about tapped out. I think we're having a carb and sugar coma from all of the snacks we've been eating.
And literally right now at the end, they're just handing them out.
Yeah, they're just handing snacks and stuff out like crazy. Just like, eat this stuff. So we're overloaded. Just kicking back, watching the DJ for the last little while.
And Chippendale.
And Chippendale dancing still. And about to call it a night. So amazing, absolutely amazing.
It was a great night.
It was a very good night. I had fun. Wow, it is 1:38 in the morning.
Yep.
And we're home from Earidescent, from the Earidescent Evenings. Check out, this is very iridescent looking, like it's shiny and stuff.
Changing color.
And I will say that we had an amazing time at Epcot. We couldn't eat another bite, but Lori's still eating popcorn.
Me too.
I've had so much popcorn.
Like literally at the end they were throwing snacks away, especially the frozen ones that, yeah, it was like...
Oh, they gave me two Mickey bars, like an ice cream bar, kind of like a Dilly bar from A&W. I pulled one out and as I pulled it out, it just fell right off the stick onto the ground. I had to scoop it into a little bag. It
because
sucked.
They have them in boxes, they were handing them out, they were not refrigerated.
Trying to get rid of them. So the last one I had to eat kind of like an ice cream bar halfway in the package. But really good time. And just, I think it's an amazing thing that Walt Disney World does for their employees. Mm-hmm. Again, you have to remember there's over 70,000 of us in Walt Disney World, Orlando.
And they have done these events
throughout July and August. Yeah. Like so, I don't know how many, whether it was 20 of them or whatever, but they had some nights at Magic, some nights at Hollywood, some nights here at Epcot.
So it was amazing.
And it's not only the food, they have entertainment and they have the characters.
It's crazy.
And you can go on the rides. And it's, I mean, there's so much to it.
As many snacks as you want to eat, as many sodas as you want to drink, it's crazy. They give you a regular map and they tell you where character experiences are. So we had some, I don't think we took any character photos together,
yeah,
but we did.
Lines were too long for us.
Lines were
but
crazy.
We took other pictures.
Yeah, some spots where there were other pictures. So it was just awesome. And I think it was a really cool thing they did. The DJ was a lot of fun hanging out and watching the DJ and people
dancing.
Chippendale
for how many hours?
Yep.
3 hours straight.
And again, Chippendale's in Vegas, a whole different show, folks. So yeah, don't confuse Chippendale's with Chip and Dale. So yeah, completely different thing. Great time. And it's something that a lot of people don't get to experience unless you're a cast member.
And
so
they give us merchandise too. They give us like the, if you're a Star Wars fan, you will know this one, popcorn bucket. They give us ears. They give us like a commemorative coin.
Yeah, the coin's really cool. I don't know where it went.
It's on top there.
It's on the top of there. But check this out. Yeah, a commemorative, this 50th anniversary coin as well. You're not going to be able to see that in the camera. Very cool. Just very, very, very cool stuff. So just super appreciative of that.
And just experience.
Just a great experience. Yeah, and to experience the park with that few people and it was pretty neat. So yeah, glad you guys could come along for a quick ride with us. And the weather was about 95% cooperative, with that first 5% kind of blew because
that
it just poured on us.
That was not even during the event. Like,
no.
We were just out roaming around, and on our way back, we got caught in the rain.
Yeah.
But it was a long time for the rain, and also it was hard rain. So yeah.
And once we walked in, it completely cleared up.
It
the
did.
Weather, the temperature was just perfect. It
they
was
literally
amazing.
Gift us ponchos, and as soon as they gave it to us, didn't rain.
Yeah, we didn't need the ponchos anymore. But it was awesome. Absolutely awesome. Glad we could share that with you folks. If this is your first time with the channel, it'd be awesome if you hung out with us a little bit and got to know us, and that means I have to
subscribe.
Hit that subscribe button. It'd be equally as cool if you like the video. And we'll see you again in the next one. We're going to have some really cool stuff coming up. So hit that subscribe button. Stick around. And we'll have some more Disney stuff, and then we'll have some more not so Disney stuff.
I'm falling asleep.
All right, let's.
It's almost 2 a.m.
All right, we're done.